is a two-edged sword for cutting and has a tapered point for thrusting. It was used by the Roman soldiers for centuries. It's a solid grip and is made for faster stabbing or cutting. Its primary infantry attack is lead with the shield, thrust with the gladius towards the abdomen. Following the Bronze Age into the Iron Age, the gladius generally was made out of steel. As early as 600 BC, it was the Greek copus, or tririum sword, that was the first of its kind, using a new technique of pattern welding which used different alloys throughout the entire blade. Far from its trusium sword, which is a single piece of steel which is a very similar design and shape. For the Romans, it was 225 BC during the Battle of Telamon against the Celts, where they came up against the Celtiberian origins, which suggests a gladius copy. And in 215 BC, it was the Battle of Cumae, where they first started using this sword. It was 220 BC when the Romans invaded the Iberian Peninsula, modern-day Spain, referred to as the Conquest of Hispania, where they came across what was referred to as the Gladius Hispania, which is just simply called the Hispanic sword. The word gladius is a Latin word believed to be Celtic, simply means sword. So there are several swords referred to as gladius, as well as the term gladiator, which simply means swordsman. But it was in 209 BC, the Battle of Cartagena, where the Roman assault with this new gladius Hispania, at the beginning of the Second Punic Wars, where Roman general Scipio Africanus absolutely demolished his enemies with this gladius sword, that the gladius sword became predominant for the Roman army. It was the rise of the Roman Republic and the sack of Carthage and Corinth in 146 BC that changed everything for Rome. It was the Battle of Corinth that the gladius dominated the longsword. This battle marked the end of the Achaean War and the start of Roman domination. And the gladius sword could not be stopped. But it was in 107 BC that Gaius Marius instigated the Marian military reforms for Rome. Prior to 107 BC, there was a class system for soldiers. The Roman soldier had to be at least fifth in its class rank and had to be a landowner. Fifth was referred to as the velites. They couldn't afford their own swords and typically fought with javelins, preceding the front lines and then retreating quickly. Then there was hastii, which were landowners that could afford basic armor and a gladius sword. Then there was the princeps, which could afford high-quality armor, shield, helmet, and sword. Triarii, which were essentially veteran princeps, and they were used typically as the last resort. And then there was the elite of the elite, the equites. These were rich citizens, equipped with everything that the princeps were, only they had horses and they're used for reconnaissance. But it was during these Marian reforms that everything changed for the Roman Empire. First and foremost of these reforms included all men. The landless masses were now able to be soldiers. The Marian reform also standardized equipment, including the gladius sword. From 107 BC, every Roman soldier was armed with a gladius sword. They're also broken up into legions, which were typically 4,800 soldiers, then cohorts and smaller centuries. Also among these reforms, typical enlistment was 20 years, which then at the end gave you full Roman citizenship. All of the Roman legions were armed with armor, shield, javelin, which is referred to as a pia, and a gladius sword. Depending on when and where the gladius sword was made, there was typically three different types. There was the Moines gladius, the Fulham gladius, and the Pompeii gladius. Again, based on location and date, they're very subtle differences. Typically, they weighed 1.5 to 2.5 pounds, had a 45 to 68 centimeter blade length, and had the width of 5 to 7 centimeters, with a hilt made of wood, bronze, or ivory. And for more than 300 years following the Marian reforms, the Roman legions, armed with the gladius sword, dominated the battlefield throughout the entire Roman Empire. This sword played a huge role in the domination of the Roman Empire, and we're still today seeing effects of what this sword did for the entire world and the history of this world. What we found with the gladius sword, like many weapons before it and after it, evil always shows its ugly head, and good must always rise against it. And its weapons, like the gladius sword, that allow us to do that. Thank you for watching this episode of The History of Weapons. Don't forget to click the subscribe and the bell button.